We have been moved to an undisclosed, secure location. We have been told to not disclose our location to anyone, nor make direct contact with anyone back home. I have not told them. I am writing up my accounts of what is happening. They would not allow this. At this point, though, I feel this is beyond the comprehension of the local police. I cannot imagine they have dealt with anything like this before. It had all calmed down over the past few days, and it felt as if the storm had finally settled. In that short time, it was as if everything had returned to some semblance of normality. I knew, though, in the back of my mind, that it was not over. The only time we had left the house was to write up an official report at the police station. There had been no new developments in the case, as far as we were aware, and no sightings of these people. That was until yesterday evening, when the sirens in the distance brought us back to reality. I hoped that they would pass us by, but as the sirens drew closer, I knew it was for us. I opened the front door to three police cars pulling up to the house. A police officer exited one of the cars and jogged up to the front door. "Sir, we need you and your family to pack a bag immediately. We need to leave as soon as possible," he said abruptly. "What's going on? Has something happened?" I said. "Sir, I need you all to pack a bag immediately and come with us," he said in a hurried tone. We all packed up a bag each and headed off into the unknown. The sincerity in the police officer's tone had made me blindly follow orders. I consistently asked questions on the way, but received no response. We sat there in silence for most of the trip, and after an hour of driving, we arrived at a house. We entered the house and were greeted by two plain-clothed police officers. We emotionlessly walked around the house as they gave us a brief tour. They then directed us to the living room and asked us to take a seat. We all sat down in the living room in silence until one of the officers spoke. "There have been some developments in the case. There will be an official report given soon. We needed to move you and your family as soon as possible, as we believe there is a serious threat to your safety," he said, before briefly pausing. I think he was expecting some kind of response, but none of us spoke a word. The officer continued. "We received reports this evening concerning a group of people congregating outside of your house. Police officers were dispatched to the scene, but when they arrived, the people had already left. The front windows to the house had all been broken and the front door was off of its hinges. The police officers entered the house at around 8 p.m. and searched the property. They entered the bedroom." He cleared his throat and wiped his brow before continuing. "They entered the bedroom of the property and found a female tied to the bed. She was spread across the bed and was pronounced dead on arrival." He cleared his throat once again and shot a worried look to his partner. His partner nodded to him and the officer continued. "The woman had been mutilated and her blood was strewn across the wall to create a message. We had to move you immediately as we feel you are in imminent danger from these people. The message said, "Not right for him. You will be." There was also a number carved into the woman's chest. It was the number 21. Does this mean anything to any of you? I thought about it, but could not come up with anything at all. That is not our age, nor is it either of our birthdays. I mentioned that it may be the amount of victims, but the officers did not seem to agree. We all sat there staring off into the distance before my girlfriend began to cry uncontrollably. I attempted to console her with my mother, but it was not much use. That could have been her laid out across that bed. That still could be. These people seem resilient, and we cannot hide forever. Seeing her in this state, my fear quickly turned to rage. I shouted at the police officers. What is the next course of action? What the hell are we supposed to do? You will need to remain here for the time being. We will be posted inside the house, and a police car will be outside. We will find these people, the officer said, turning to face me. The police officers exited the room on that note and gave us some time alone. We must sit there for an hour in silence before we finally decided to head off to sleep. The police being inside and outside of the house allowed us to regain some kind of feeling of security. They could not know where we were. That would be impossible. They would surely not come to the house with the police here anyway. I waited for my girlfriend to pass out from exhaustion before I finally managed to fall asleep myself. I awoke several times throughout the night. It was not the cult that was haunting my dreams. It was that doll. The featureless face was more detailed with each passing nightmare. They all had the exact same theme, and it was almost an out-of-body experience. I was watching myself and my girlfriend sleeping from the far wall. I was glued to the spot, unable to move. The doll was at the end of the bed, with its back towards me in the first nightmare. I awoke suddenly, but quickly passed out again soon after, brushing it off. The next time, it had slowly began to turn its head. I awoke in a panic and searched around the room and under the bed. I knew I was being crazy, but I could not help it. I felt like something was watching me, and it sent a shiver down my spine. I finally fell asleep again a little while later. The next nightmare lasted a little bit longer. It had turned its head and it was facing my direction. It had stitching where the eyes and mouth would be. The stitching was moving vigorously as if something was attempting to break the stitching away. It would be as if you had duct tape on your mouth and eyes and were desperately trying to remove it without access to your hands. This one unsettled me a little bit more than the others, but once again I somehow managed to fall back to sleep. I was so tired at this point that I could not keep my eyes open even if I wanted to. In the final nightmare, before I woke this morning, it had broken free from the stitching. It was looking directly at me. The stitching had been replaced with endless pools of darkness. I could sense the evil within the stare. I could feel the sweat dripping down from my forehead. I looked down and the long arm at the side of the doll was gently caressing my girlfriend's leg as it looked towards me. It was all just a nightmare, but every time I close my eyes, I swear that I can see it. I think I must just be exhausted from this whole situation. I have barely slept over the past week, and I think everything is getting to me now. We are prisoners in this house. We cannot leave or contact anyone on the outside. This is my only means of communication with the outside world. I do not feel safe. I think that these people will do anything in their power to make sure she is theirs. I feel that they are just biding their time. There must be a reason why. I think that the number 21 must have something to do with all of this. It's in the dustiest books that you may find the best stories.